gonna do a video about Sephora. This is maybe the biggest haul that I ever done for since like a little bit long, because in here I tried to make use of this Sephora Rouge account, and then I bought quite a few things, and the value of these I think the value of these are up to $500. So the haul today is like $500 worth of Sephora sales item. So let's see what I bought and make it for it. The box, only one come first, and then the second one is like I bought it the last day, since it's I was thinking about if I should get it more or not, but I ended up buying a little bit more and it came in. So I'll unbox these two at the same time and then see what inside. I open the box. This is really heavy. So this one's like this. But I'm almost out of the so I decided to get the new one that I'm gonna use instead of my little one money. Oh well, since I'm ready for the money, let's see what I have today. So let me count the place that I'm gonna pick. Rejuvenating facial essence. Coupon. So I use Hue's brand a lot now, and then this one is one of the things that really makes me like this essence, and it's like something extra because I'm running out of it, so what I'm doing now is just toner, serum, moisturizer, that's it. But with this extra stuff, the essence, it's gonna help moisturize your skin and then it's absorb the serum better. And I have this because it's like it's a bit of natural and nearby ferulic acid, lactic acid, and squalene oil. So it's like it absorbs quickly into skin to visibly reduce fine lines, rejuvenate skin texture, boost healthy radiance. Wow. I think it's my second bottle, second or third. I bought a smaller bottle before. This is my third bottle. Same bottle inside. So you see this product? It's like totally different layers. One is the essence, and there's a thin layer of the oil. Depending on how you use, you need to shake it. So the oil and the liquid at the bottom mix together, and it will create the essence that you want to use and apply on your face. And it, let's see. I think it's medic in here, it's very herbal, very earthy, that's a good one. I'm okay with it, I don't have any problem with this. I think it's a good one, but I don't even know, I'm just having this skin here now, so I'm going to go into it. This one, this is a body brown. But I mean, enrich face base. There's a all-in-one brown and moisturizer. So this is, I think, like a face moisturizer before makeup, so it's like a kind of like creamy and kind of a little bit thick cream for your face, so you know when you apply the first layer of the either the concealer or the foundation, your skin on like a thin layer of like a stickiness. So this helps like create that thin layer, and then it helps like keep the foundation on for longer and like stick to your skin, and it's not like going anywhere. It's really really good, and it's super moisturizing. Even though my skin is combination too oily, I still like this one. So I use this for the makeup base most of the time. When we have a moisturizer, I use this as a moisturizer serum that is worked for those groups well for daily basic or even night day. But I think it would work super nicely for any of you guys who have dry skin, and then it would be perfect for just using it as a primer for your face. It would create a really nice thin layer of prepare for a new layer of foundation on top. So yeah, if you want to try this medium size version of this, you can try it before buying a full size. I think this is a full size. But nice guy, let's try. Next is this one. See, it has Laura Mercier. This is a translucent blue setting powder. I don't know how many of these I've already used, because I really like this one. Since I discovered the Laura Mercier one, the translucent powder, I don't really use other products. Sometimes I try some new powder or loose powder from Korean brand, but most of the time I always come back to this, and it works nicely on my skin. It's like you can make your face with it, or you can use it at a thin layer. The powder is super like fine, and it's like really smooth on your skin. This is kind of like blur all the pores away. I bought this one, I don't know how many times already, and the old one I almost now. So this is like a review for the next time that I use. But this use, I use this one like a lot, almost every day as I go to work. So I always apply a thin layer of concealer and then the loose powder, and it helps close all my pores and create a nicely like perfect skin, I would say. Super nice. There's a lot of other high-end, a little bit more expensive loose powder that I haven't tried out there. Maybe it's gonna be good or better, but for now I use this every day. It works fine with my skin, so I always come back to this. This one is my all-time favorite. It's like I use this mainly. No, I use it a lot. Like I bought it more than 10 times already. I bought it from a clinic store, but since I'm using Sephora account, I bought it on Sephora, so it's a little bit cheaper, or I can use my points to redeem like $10 off of these. But the combo size is very, very like useful, and it's a lot. You can use this as is, like a moisture search. It's a 100-hour outdoor auto-replenishing hydrator. So this helps your skin moisturize really well. My skin, I told you guys a few times, it's a combination oily. So this one is like a water-based kind of moisturizer that doesn't feel too thick on my skin, and it's helping my skin breathe, and it's absorbed super well. And especially it's almost summertime, so I would recommend this type of product. You don't want to put too much of moisturizer on your skin during summer, because it's hot and you want to wrap it sweating. So this is kind of really nice, and you can just go a long way up this super big jar. I use it for like a good few months, because I usually use it as a moisturizer myself, but sometimes you can use it as like extra layer of moisturizing your skin before your makeup. Or like I saw a lot of other YouTubers, they said that they use this as a foundation corrector, because you know when you draw out your eyeliner, or it's a mistake, or like your skin has become a little bit cakey, you can use this as like a base thin layer, and it helps to create as nice surface again to apply new layer of foundation or cushion, or even fix the little black eyeliner that leaves down, like smush down your eyes. So this is my all time comeback. Like I try a lot of different brands, moisturizer brands, but always come back to this, because you know that it's a little bit more expensive, but it's worth it. It's worth every penny. It's like it doesn't fail me. There's that. The rest of these two items are new to me, so I never used this before. But because you know, when you watch a lot of YouTube video, makeup related YouTube videos, and you saw the YouTuber bought these or use this, and the result is nice, and they're highly recommended about this. So I decided to give it a try. Especially here, and a lot of good things about these products. These things, the rest in the box. So why not? I feel like I'm wasting money for this. Unless this is really blew my mind away, because I always be a fan of NARS creamy concealer. And since I started using NARS, I don't really use other high-end concealer. I use other Korean brand concealer, and it works fine, even though it's not really, really stay on, and it doesn't really last all day. But it does a trick for like a short period of makeup, where you just need to go out and something, and need to cover your blemishes and imperfection. That's fine. But NARS is like my everywhere. It's just like I don't use foundation for everyday work. I go to work, I don't use foundation or cushion unless I feel like it. But I use only concealer, and I use NARS cream concealer for basically every single day. Then I think my last few weeks I saw a girl reviewing about this foundation, this concealer, and I said, huh, it's the Dior. Should I don't know. this may want that. And I feel like the higher end, more like a Chanel or Tiffany brand, you're gonna see different results. Some people like it and some people don't. And it's kind of like hit or miss. And I was thinking, maybe since my skin even though I have some problem, but it's pretty in pretty good condition, and because that's why I don't need to use a lot of foundation or concealer on my face. I want my face to be able to breathe. No, that's why I decided, why not try it out? Try it out to see if it works, and you guys can try it out too. And I bought this concealer in because I always like to wear concealer like a shade darker than my skin. So I bought this one. I hope it's not gonna be too rough, too light, like too white for me. But let's see. So it's a big kind of concealer, and the application is a little bit big too. This reminds me of the Tarte concealer. I use it like that, but at one point I just figured out it's way too big for my skin, and it's gonna make my face a bit kinky. So I decided to stop using it, but it's a good one. Right here. Oh wow, not bad. See, I think it's kind of matching my skin pretty well, and it's kind of like a neutral. So you know, my skin is a little bit more, I feel like it's a neutral color, but sometimes I feel like it's yellow. A warm undertone a little bit, but I do like the neutral color on your skin tone, and I feel like I can do well with that color. That's why I use I always buy something that more in the middle, like kind of neutral, not too cool, not too warm. I think it might work. Just feel like it's not too thick for a concealer, and it's a 24-hour wear and hydration creamy concealer, full coverage. Well, full coverage. I don't need to use foundation, just like my NARS creamy concealer one. Well, I'll show you guys how it's on my skin maybe tomorrow or one of the day when I start using this. But it's a Dior brand, you guys. Dior. Hopefully it's be good. This must be good. This must be good. High expectation for this one. Don't disappoint me, okay? Next item is, this is some Rare Beauty. You know the Rare Beauty brand? It's a little Gomez brand. I never use it. I feel like maybe celebrity brand. I only use Fenty Beauty. I don't really trust any other brand from a celebrity. But then I feel like Rare Beauty has become so popular with among Asian skin kind of community. So I feel like it's worth a try. And as a Sephora big sale, I want to try it out if it's really good with my skin. It said it's a positive light silky touch highlighter, and it's in the shade of Exhilarate. An ultra silky powder highlighter that melts onto the skin for an effortless iridescent glow. Wow. Oh yeah, this one is like on one of the YouTube videos, and I saw that girl is just using a little brush and just apply onto like your nose and your nose bridge, and it's like brighten up the face. It's like, I don't have that yet. I want to have that before I get it. Let's see. Wow, how cute. It's like a soft pastel color. It's a super nice design. Oh my god. Look at that. Oh my god. Can you see that? Wow, you guys, it surprised me. You see how my jaw dropped? Wow, it's like a soft silky, just like a package said, silky touch. And it's like a kind of like rose goldish gold. I think it's more gold, but it's so cute. Oh my god, unbelievable. I can't wait to try this. Wow, I'm excited now. Next one, the same brand, Rare Beauty. I think it is a blush. It said a stay vulnerable melting blush, nearly neutral is the shade. And it said this breakthrough formula delivers a weightless wash of soft focus color that melts upon contact for a second skin finish. It's me that I love the idea of doing makeup without makeup, and it's just like make your skin glowy, and then you don't have to use a lot of powder or like to layer it. I want it to look like that, but you guys know what happened. My skin is oily, and then if I don't put a layer of powder on top, you will see it's got oily like super fast. So that's why I don't have that glowy effect on my skin. Sometimes I like it, but sometimes I feel like I want my skin to glow. I should do it. I start to like my beauty packaging. It's so, so cute. What's that color? Oh my god, look at this. Let's see. What is this? That's cute. It's like, that's really, really bland. Like a, and you know, it's kind of like, it's cream, but when you take this, it's like still cream. But when you apply it on your skin, it becomes powder. So you know, it becomes powder, you guys. And it's like bland, like magic. It's like blends super well. It's unbelievable. I can't believe I'm saying this. And I really like how a lot of blush, because I know it's only like okay, and you have a lot of options too far to choose from. But this is like something else, or maybe I haven't tried anything like this before. I use cream before, but it's never had this kind of texture or like this silky finish that is exactly like I said. Wow. Try my more products are already ready now to try. Maybe I should. Crazy. Oh my god, it's so beautiful color, you guys. This one is from Summer Friday. I think this brand is kind of new. New, but not too new for the people on social media. I think it's become super popular and all the colors are become like a trend or like a big hit, because it's a really nice color, and it's known like, I think this is mainly, my purpose is moisturizing your lips. I think more of a lip. Oh, it's like a lip butter balm. And I got the color vanilla beige. Let's see. Oh, and also this one is vegan, so it is healthy for the environment, and then it's help like heal in your lips and keep your lips moist, and then give a little bit of color too. It's gonna be like this. I think it's gonna have the same color. So the application is on, and I have to try a minute. Can you guys see? Like basically the color is pretty cute neutral nude color. Is that vanilla? Okay, I think it's more like a neutral undertone here, and I have a hint of a blush, brownish, orange. It's soft and moisturizing, and then it's not sticky on your lips. That's the main thing. I don't really lip balm at all, because I you know the feeling when you top and then your lips touch and it has that little things that stick together, and I don't like that at all. But maybe I'm gonna like it. Who knows? I do something I wanna wear this often, because I drink a lot of water every day, so I need a cream. It's there in the bottle. And then it's not everywhere, and then it's not gonna keep on my lips for like that long, but I'm gonna try it. Maybe it's gonna help make my lips look better. Two more things, so I'm almost done. I mean, almost done with this box. There's one more box. Oh yeah, or maybe I'm gonna just introduce you guys the because the second box is about lipstick too, so I'm gonna make the next video that introduce all the lipstick that I bought during the Sephora haul. $500 worth of Sephora haul. So besides this one, maybe this one is a giveaway, like a like a sneak peek for you guys. But this, I bought the Fenty Beauty one, and I bought a YSL. It's all recommended by watching YouTube video. So I'm gonna push down. So these three, and I have another YSL lipstick, Phuong lipstick, and a Nars lipstick. So I'm gonna on my next video, I'm gonna swatch and try on all these lipstick reviews on my Sephora haul. And if you guys like any of these, maybe if I'm reaching 3,000 subscribers. I'm gonna give away one of these for you guys as an appreciation present, like a gift. My appreciation to you guys. So keep in mind the shade and color, and help me reach 3,000 subscriber, YouTube subscriber. I'm gonna give away one of these, and I'm gonna let you guys know when to enter or when I'm gonna give away this. So don't forget to like and subscribe my channel, and I'll see you in my next lips videos. Don't go anywhere, okay? Bye bye. Good night. It's super dark. And I'm ready. Oh my god, I don't have a lot more to say, but good night. Good night. See you soon. These are all the products that I'm doing today. Me even done my makeup and my lip. I think I'm gonna see better with my makeup on. So I'm gonna keep my makeup on tomorrow during the lips video. So don't go away, okay? Bye bye, bye bye, bye bye. See you soon.